Hey folks, so for today's video, I want to expound a little bit upon the vlogging setup that I was talking about last week. It's the Canon M, whoa, bright, too bright. So what I want to talk about today is the Rode Video Micro Plus, I believe it is. It's on the top of this vlogging camera. There are a few things I've learned about this microphone after using it for the last couple of months. So let's go into the studio and I'll talk about five different things to look out for when you're using the Rode Video Micro or whatever it is. Let's go. Off to the studio. Okay, so this is the vlogging setup I was talking about. I got the Canon M50 again, but this isn't really about the Canon M50. It's really about the microphone on top. I've got a couple of tips, like I said, after I've been using this camera for so many months. So first thing, just so you know, this is called a windscreen, and if I take the windscreen off, here's the microphone here. This goes on the top of the camera, okay? So the first thing you want to do, now I didn't do this before, and I had to, well, right click delete a couple of videos. This little screw thing, I'll zoom in a little bit closer. This cap here, if this is loose and it's inside here and you don't know it, it can easily jiggle as you're moving and walking and vlogging and that sort of thing. And that, just that little play in that thread there, doesn't sound real good. Just make sure that that's tight. And if you have a problem with that thing coming off, I'm sure you could put a little piece of gaff tape on there to secure it, or Loctite or something. So just make sure that that's tight every once in a while, or there's a good chance you might ruin your audio. Oh, we are recording. Okay, perfect. So now we gotta sync this. Jesus. Second tip is to use this windscreen, especially if you're outside, because it really does cut down on the noise and the, well, the wind. It's called a dead cat. Basically, my second tip is to use this thing, and when you do put it on, make sure that it is pushed in the whole way and it kind of sits nice and tug. It's designed to go in the whole way and stay nice and tug. Snug, tug, whatever. So that's my second tip, is just to make sure that this is installed properly and securely. Not really sure, I guess it resembles a dead cat. My next tip is really just about setting up the input level on this microphone. Now, if you go to the back of the camera on the Canon M50 itself, so if you go to menu, camera setting here, I'll zoom in on this. Item number one, if you go down to sound recording, I recommend going to manual instead of automatic. I recommend going to set the record level to around 50%, maybe a little bit higher than 50%. If they're pegging at zero, then you might want to turn those down, which mine are now, actually. You really want to be at around 12 dB, and I only know that from a couple of other videos I've watched. I'm kind of resharing information. I'm like a conduit of information, if you would. So anyway, I'm talking into this thing about the distance that I will be hovering around 12 dB. I think I'm gonna lower that sensitivity even a little bit more. All right, so, well, actually it's a little bit less than 50%. Yeah, for me about 40% seems to be good. So my fourth recommendation is really just to get as close to the microphone as possible. Now that includes something else. There are going to be times when you're out vlogging that you might want to actually do some B-roll, or you might want to take the camera, turn it around this way and get it off of your face and record some other things. And you might want to do a little bit of narration with that at the same time. So I recommend just flipping the microphone around on the hot shoe like such. Boy, this is really a half-assed video. Now, here's the thing. When you're doing this, there's a good chance that the microphone is gonna bobble down in the way of the sensor that's right here, and it's gonna keep shutting off the display like you see right there. Very annoying. Here's a tip. I just learned this one today. So in the back of the plastic thumb tightening thingy, there are these little grooves, which I will show you in more detail. If you take the microphone cable and just snap it into any one of those grooves and move the cord up and over the viewfinder, that keeps this microphone from wobbling, because this cord is holding down the tension and preventing this thing from bouncing. But what that also does is, when you switch the microphone around, it keeps that dead cat from hitting this sensor right here. Follow what I'm saying? You see how that's happening? We want to eliminate that. So that's it, that's five tips. It's a five tip Wednesday, essentially. So that leads me to my recommended channel of the week. I gotta go find my phone because I forget his name. Hold on. Incidentally, I know I like shooting these five tip Wednesday videos, whatever they are, in black and white, but I just wanna show you what it looks like in color. So I'm kind of working in my studio here. I'm gonna be recording some other videos on some other topics and some basically photography related quick tips, that sort of thing. And I'm working with my lighting and I've just been playing with things. I don't wanna go into detail what I'm doing just yet, but I just wanted to kind of show you what this looks like in color. The light over here, a side light here, a soft box here, a down light on the wood, and another slash thing going on. Minimal details. So my recommended channel, if I can find it, stand by, Cody Wanner, W-A-N-N-E-R. I'll do a link to his thing here. Anyway, he was the guy, just his video popped up in my recommended video viewing stream thing that's in YouTube, whatever. And he was the one that I saw, and this was my fifth and most important tip for me, how to get that microphone to stop from bouncing around and actually causing noise in and of itself. I don't know why I didn't realize to just do that, to just put the cable right in the clip the way it's designed. Not sure where I missed that in the directions. Anyway, check out Cody's channel. He's got a lot of really cool stuff, collaborations with Peter McKinnon, Casey Neistat. Not sure why I've never heard of him before, but I highly recommend watching a few other of his videos. Pretty funny. That's all I got for this week. As I always say, more on all of this later. Thank you.